don't plan to stay should have themselves together and take the room that they expect. Because we cannot expect that the police are going to be reasonable. We hope that they're reasonable. They hope that they're reasonable. People who have outstanding warrants, you know, if you go to jail, you're going to stay in jail for a while. Number two, people who have citizenship issues, we really usually suggest that people who are here on a visa or from here, if you're a citizen, that you should not risk being arrested. Pardon me. If you're a resident, the same thing. I think that if you are a resident, you put your ability to stay as a resident at risk. So we encourage anybody who's not a citizen to check with their own embassy or check with their own private immigration lawyer, because you know what's going on in jails in the United States now for people who are just either are undocumented or are not here. Even with a green card, if you have a green card, you can check it. You're going to stay longer. They're going to run your fingerprints through the ICE and the FBI. You will be in jail longer. Part of the thing is, whenever we have these gatherings, not everybody shows up. So you all have to come communicate this to the people who don't show up. So really make sure to protect them, because the consequence for some people is not just an arrest and jail and everything. The consequence is they'll be deported. It shouldn't be that. It's wrong. It's unjust. But that's what the risk that people are taking. Have a certain give them permission. They always say in court is that everybody gave me permission. It was okay for me to search his tent, and in his tent I found his army. Let's make clear from the beginning that you do not give the permission to search. They'll probably search anyway, but don't give them, you do not have to give consent. That's your constitutional right. These rights, you don't always obtain them. Any questions on what I've said so far?
You know, that's a good point you just brought up, that they don't pay attention. They're work for, they don't pay attention to our constitutional rights as a police officer or a civil servant, and they do not abide by the laws that they're supposed to be working on. Well, that's all I got to say.
Everybody heard that even though those are the rights, the police don't pay attention to them, they're often violated. You know that going in, we all know that. But that doesn't mean, you should be able to say, everybody here, I don't consent to them, do whatever you do, whatever they're going to do, you don't consent.
It's kind of like, if somebody touches me in a bad way, being a female or something like that, you could say, I don't like this.
Right.
I don't want this. Yeah. Make sure to. My brain is tired out of that.
Reputation speaks for itself. I'd like to know your advice, or if you had the magic button, what would you like to see Occupy NOLA do in the face of eviction?
Well, I've done a lot of these things, and I find that everybody has a different response, and that it's important to respect that. Is that, some people will resist right up to the end, and then they're going to walk away and fight another day. And that's perfectly okay.
I know people are out here for just this reason, this fight. And, you know, the fight's not going to end this day. Some people say, look, I've had it. I'm going to go to jail. If you go to jail, we will represent you. We will work to try. Miles will explain how long you'll be in jail, that stuff. But you're going to risk losing your stuff, so it's a big sacrifice. So I don't think it's fair to expect everybody to risk going to jail. The thing is, if they clear people out today, I know that there's some people figure, well, then we'll come out. We have another place in mind where we're going to go. We have another, we come back at another day. We will let this pass and then come back in a new way. So I think that it's important to respect every person's individual choice about this. And I don't think we can go wrong as long as we respect people's decision about it. What's really important is that we don't get into, okay, well, if you leave, you're chicken shit or something like that, okay? That can't, we can't do it like that. And we can't say, well, if I'm tough, I'm going to stay. It's not tough, it's not chicken, none of that stuff. It's decisions about what people are making about how best to live a life of justice and resistance. And that I've represented many people who have gone to jail, and I've represented many people who walk away and fight again another day. So I don't think there's one answer. Most of them, that's my opinion. I've represented thousands of people. It's not one answer. You can make whatever you decide to be an action of dignity and resistance. And some of us pay a lot bigger price to go to jail. People in poor health, LGBTQ folks, people of color, young people, stuff like that. There's different consequences to going to jail. Some of us need medicine. Some of us can't go 24 hours without food and stuff like that. So we have to respect all of them. I think that'd be my opinion.
Is there anything about what you expect after?
So what's going to happen? You're going to be put in the back of the van. You're going to be put in the back of a police cruiser. You're probably going to get taken to central lockup. And they're going to search through all your stuff. They're going to make you empty your pockets. They might be found that before you're thrown in the back. But they're going to give you at least another thorough search once you get through the processing. They're processing you. They're going to take your picture. They're going to ask you for some more information, your first name, your social security number, that sort of stuff. At that point, you're probably going to get thrown in a big holding cell with a bunch of other people. And you're going to sit there and wait until you either go see a magistrate judge or, they set a bond. Now, the magistrate judges, they generally set bonds three times a day, once in the morning and once in the afternoon, once in the evening. So depending on when you're arrested, sort of dictates when you're going to get your bond set. Now, we don't know if these are going to be state charges or municipal charges. State charges, yes, you go to a magistrate. Municipal charges or city charges, you would go to one of the municipal judges. And they set bonds sort of along the same way as several times a day. If people are arrested en masse, we will try to get people out as quickly as possible, and we will reach out to the judges, but we can't guarantee that. So you might be in there, and we might not see you until, or you might see us when you get to arraignment. At arraignment, at the bond setting, the judge is going to set a bond, they're not going to discuss your charges or anything like that. We're going to argue that for a low bond and you get released. If there are municipal charges, you might, you get a bond set, we might be able to plead you not guilty at that point, just ask that you get released as well. But it's going to be at least 8, maybe even 12 hours before you get into court, into a courtroom where you get released. And even once the bond is set, and the judge calls in a bond and you get released, or you paid your bond, it could take several hours after that for you to get released. So it's not going to be at all quick procedure.
On December 20th, 2007, the problem wasn't us going to jail. The problem wasn't getting arrested and then getting, we had a few difficulties. One of the problems we ran into was they put us in vans next to the Superdome, and the chef is there for 3 hours. There was no bathroom facility.
Okay. When some of us were arrested on December 20th, 2007, protesting the city council's decision to close the to demolish the project, we were not taken directly to jail. We were put in vans. First, we were put in like paddy wagons, part irish. Anyway, we were put in police vans. We were let to sit there for an hour and a half, and then they took us over to the sports arena near the Superdome and put us and handcuffed us to the seats of a school bus. So it took us about 3 hours to get there, and that created problems for some of us who had to use the bathroom. People were thirsty. It was very uncomfortable. So we actually were in a position where we wanted to get to jail, but I just wanted to bring that up for y'all to be aware of that, that might be a problem if any of you about it.
There's not a lot we can do about it. They're probably going to make an estimate of how many people they think are going to be arrested. They're probably going to hold people there for a little bit before they take everyone to central lockup. And you might not be able to use the bathroom for a long time. So we just don't know, but that's a good scenario of how it might take place.
Let's take a little commercial here. Then, in terms of the filing of suit against the city, temporary restraining order, we have 5 people who signed up to be a party to that suit. We could use about 4 or 5 more. This doesn't mean that you have to be willing to be arrested or anything like that. Just that you're here and you're interested in challenging the situation that the city saying people have to leave. It's not that you don't have to take a risk to be arrested. If you're interested in suing, give your name to Matt or to Vito. Okay?
Another question. Will you call the UTR and speak on that too?
I don't know, if you're here, if you've been here, and you want to stay here, that's the
requirement. And the requirement that you step in the park, that you bend the park, is that a requirement?
No, I think it, that you have to come back and forth, and you think it's important that people be able to stay, you know, around the clock.
Whether you live here or not?
Whether you live here or not, no, that's part of what you're doing, that you support the community.
I was wondering about sidewalks. If we're asked to leave, we would like to remain sort of vocal presence. And we move to the sidewalk. Are we then out of harm's way? Are we out of the possibility of being arrested for violations of the code that sort of goes on?
I would not. I mean, the sidewalks are supposed to be available for anybody in the public at any time. So legally, I would say if you're on the sidewalk watching, you have some protection. The fact is that when police get nervous and do this sort of thing, they're going to tell people to move on. If they don't move on, they're going to make something up. So, I mean, I think legally, yes, you have a right to be on the sidewalk, but that doesn't mean you won't get arrested. If they tell you to move and you don't move, they'll make up something else. And they're not going to write in the report that you were on the sidewalk. They're going to say you refused to cooperate or you were... So, that's what I would just say to be very careful about. But you're right, that is a public place, and people should be able to do it.
I hope that the dog is back.
Understanding that the force of the park was there where you have the state property. Again, sort of the same thing with the sidewalk. The police are probably just going to come in here. If they see you over there, they're probably just going to arrest you anyways, either make up something or not, and then, you know, just arrest you anyways. They might be able to use that as an argument down the road, but that's not going to stop you probably from getting arrested.
If we want to stand in the car.
Probably not. Probably the only thing that's going to keep us getting arrested is
nothing.
Okay, that's fine.
Well, I'm on parole. I just did 40 years in the day. But I'm going to go back.
I don't think there's many judges who would actually say that. But it is a rule.
I have a collection of these notices that the police have been passing out, and we managed to get a couple of them autographed. But I'm wondering if we can extract them, are going to give them something a little bit more formal, or is it, there's no way of knowing that before they actually come in and ask you for release? Do you know, have any idea about that?
I don't think so. They'll probably come in here maybe with a bullhorn. They might make a general announcement. They might do a 10 to 10. We don't know. I don't expect that we give any more written notices, anything different than this. I expect we'll probably give some sort of
It sort of depends. We don't know. Sometimes they might charge you with state charges, in which case, if you're in central lockup, you're going to be with everyone else that's been arrested from the dome, from people in the quarters, everywhere. Everyone. If it's municipal charges, then you might go through an area where you're with people who are arrested on traffic tickets for DUI, that sort of stuff, lunch and stuff. So it just depends. We don't know. But yes, there's a chance that
we might be the general population. We just don't know. Don't know how long you're going to be in there for. It just depends on how quickly you get before a judge, and once your bond is set, whether you can make that bond or if you can get your release on your own recognizance or a free bond.
Just one more point about what could happen. When we were arrested on December 20th, 2007, after we finally got to jail, we were put at the health facility, commissary, health commissary. And eventually we got out, the sheriff let us out. But anyway, we were all let out within about 2-3 hours after the city council. That's another possibility. They can put everybody in a group in another facility like the hospital at Punch Prison. We don't know.
That certainly could be a possibility. They could fast track everyone. They could be prepared to arrest everyone and process them separately from everyone else. It's certainly a possibility. We just don't know. Come together and have a strategy of how they're going to put in bond.
if you're going to be arrested. That's something you need to consider.
Are you coming with us?
No, no, we can't guarantee that we'll get a judge to release you.
You might not
have a trial.
Okay.
There's no guarantee. If you have a couple hundred bucks that you can get out of jail, you don't want to stay in jail, make sure somebody that you know has that and can get in touch with the legal people and that stuff to bond you out in case that's what the judge is doing.
Any other questions?
Okay, it's very important that those who sign up to be a part of this group, write down a little bit of information about themselves. And that people keep track of those phone numbers to let everybody know what they're up to.
Thank you.